So these are the ratios you're going to need to memorize. Sine, opposite over hypotenuse, cosine, adjacent over hypotenuse, and tangent, opposite over adjacent. Now, some people teach it as SOH CAH TOA, so I'm going to show you where that comes from. SOH CAH TOA is so, which is sine, which is opposite over hypotenuse. Cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse, and tangent is opposite over adjacent. So this is SOH CAH TOA. So it's really up to you. You can memorize it this way, you can memorize it this way, SOH CAH TOA, or just those ratios. Okay, so when do we use these? We use these three trig functions when we don't have special right triangles. You just learned 45, 45, 90s, and 30, 60, 90s. So when you don't have those special angles at the acute angles, then you're going to use your trig functions. So let's just for a second say that our reference angle here is theta. So we're going to say angle C is our theta angle, or our reference angle. From angle C, the opposite side would be this leg that is across the triangle. So this one would become the opposite side. Now the hypotenuse is always opposite the right angle, so let's go ahead and label the hypotenuse. And then the second leg that we don't have labeled is the adjacent leg, and it's considered adjacent because it's next to the reference angle. It's the leg that forms the reference angle with the hypotenuse, so that's the adjacent. So from angle C, this side AB is opposite, side BC is adjacent, and side AC is the hypotenuse. Okay, now let's look at how you actually use these to solve. Okay, so I'm going to draw up the problem you have here. So we have a right triangle, and notice our reference angle is 52 degrees. So it's not a special right triangle, and that's why we're going to use trig with this one. Okay, so I've got the steps over here on the right side for you. Okay, the first step is we're going to find the reference angle. Then we're going to label our opposite, adjacent, and hypotenuse based on that reference angle. Then we're going to decide which trig function we're going to use when we're going to set it up. So the first part I'm going to show you is just how to do these four steps. Then on the second page, we're going to go through actually solving those. Okay, so let's look at this setup. We want to use this 52 degree angle as our reference angle. So from this 52 degree angle, this side is the opposite. This side is the hypotenuse. So that means the side that's labeled 12 is my adjacent side. Okay, so which two sides are we using? Well, there's no marking, there's no length, and our X is not on the hypotenuse. So we're not going to use hypotenuse. We're going to use the opposite side in the adjacent side. So go back and look at your reference. Which trig ratio, I'll jot them up here, opposite, hypotenuse, adjacent, hypotenuse, opposite, adjacent. Which one uses the opposite side in the adjacent side? Well, that's our tangent. So that's how we decide which trig function to use. So let's set up the tangent of theta. Well, theta in this case is our reference angle, so we're taking the tangent of 52 degrees, and that's equal to the opposite side over the adjacent side. So now we're going to write a ratio. Opposite is X, we don't know that side. Adjacent is 12. And that is how we set it up. So there's the first part.